days.
Another one easy to play with.
Please join me in the call to worship. Come, let us dwell in God's shelter. Let us dwell in God's work of art. Come, because the earth is the Lord's, and God's earth is our home. We live in God's world. We are not alone. We share this life with the heavens and the earth, with the waters and the land, with trees and grasses, with fish, birds, and animals, with minerals and creatures of every form, and with all our brothers and sisters. God is good, and everything God makes is good. God is love, and everything God makes is love's fruit. Let us worship God.
Thank you. This is the day that the Lord has made. Let us rejoice and be glad in it. Welcome to worship at Hennepin Avenue United Methodist Church on this glorious Sunday as we gather together to worship God who has given us the gift of this amazing creation. Entrusted us so that we can care for one another and for the whole of creation. We gather to worship. We set aside our anxiety. We set aside all that is on our hearts and minds this morning to simply come before God, who is worthy of our praise and thanksgiving. We lay ourselves before God and surrender all that we are and all that we have so that God can touch our hearts in this time of worship together. We welcome all who are joining us today by live stream, all of you who are here today, guests and members of Hennepin. We are so glad that you are here. We are in the midst of a green face series where we have been exploring what it means to be stewards of God's creation, to take a stand and to be prophetic in a world that sometimes does not seem to care about the degradation that is occurring on our globe every single day. We are here as people of God to stand firm in our resolve to be the change we hope to see in this world, for the earth is crying out.
Thank you.
blessed are. God said in Genesis that we would be a blessed people so that other nations might be blessed as well. Hear the good news. We serve a God who is full of mercy and compassion, who has poured out mercies new every morning that we might pour them into the world, that we might be a blessing to all creation.
Rejoice, rejoice, and be exceedingly glad, for great is your reward in heaven. Blessed are the poor in spirit, for theirs is the kingdom of heaven. Blessed are those who mourn, for they shall be comforted. Blessed are the meek, for they shall inherit the earth. Rejoice, rejoice, and be exceedingly glad. For great is your reward in heaven. Blessed are those who hunger and thirst after righteousness, for they shall be
Wow. This is worship at Hennepin, and again, we're so glad you're here. I'm Frenchie McGee, Associate Pastor, and I'm here to share a little bit with you about the life and work of the church. There's some things we want you to know about today. Today is an important day in the life of our congregation because there's a lot going on. First and foremost, you need to know that there is no brunch today. Normally we offer the best meal you can get in Minneapolis for $10. It's 37 feet of food, but there's no brunch today because we're having charge conference after this service. And so I want to make sure that you understand a few things about charge conference, so I'm going to come back to that in a minute. But next Sunday, June 9th, is Pentecost. It's also the last Sunday of our dear friend and associate pastor, Nate Melcher. Nate is moving to Richfield United Methodist to become their senior pastor, and we will celebrate his ministry with us next Sunday at 8:30 in Sacred Journey and here at 10 o'clock. If you want to share good wishes with Nate, and you want to do that in an individual card, there will be baskets around the sanctuary so that you can write a note to him and to his family, to Kelly and the girls, and let them know how he has blessed us as he's been with you. So you're invited to do that. He's going to celebrate communion at 8:30 in Sacred Journey. So next Sunday is going to be an amazing celebration. It is Pentecost. It is a celebration of ministry, and it is a celebration of our volunteers. It is Servant Sunday, which means that if you are a part of making this community go, our volunteers are part of the engine that makes it work, and we're going to celebrate you next week. That's June 9th. On June 23rd, we will say farewell to our dear friend Andrew Hackett, who is moving to be with his family, and so that is also coming. Now, let me return to Charge Conference. Today, we have on the charge conference agenda two issues. The first is the ability to allow our trustees to market and sell koinonia. The second is the election of our slate of congregational leaders for next year. Charge conference is not just a voting opportunity. For us as Wesleyans, as Methodists, charge conference is worship. From the earliest time of John Wesley's calling a community together, the idea of bringing the people together to listen to the Spirit and to make decisions for their community guided by the Spirit is integral to who we are and how we live. And so worship doesn't end when this service ends. Charge Conference is worship. In order to make that happen successfully, the center area, the center to center two sections will be the bar. The bar is where members of Hennepin will sit. The bar is where you will take your vote from, and the bar is where deliberations will be heard from. If you are here and you love this community and you want to observe, you may sit in the side sections, but the two center sections are reserved for members. Only members may vote, and you must be present to vote. That is in accordance with our discipline. If you need a pencil, they are in the pews. When we leave this service, you are invited to exit out to Carlson Hall. Find the table that begins with the first letter of your last name. The tables are arranged in alphabetically. There are three tables. You will receive your ballot. Your name will be checked off. Get your cinnamon roll, get a cup of coffee, get some juice, and then come back so that we can continue in this sacred space to do God's work for this community. I think that's all. Let's continue in this amazing worship service. Thank you.
The earth is the Lord's and everything in it. And God's glory covers the earth as the waters over the sea. The trees of the field clap their hands. The birds of the air sing songs of praise.
And if we should fail to express our worship, even the rocks and stones would cry out.
And so we lift up our hearts and voices to join all creation in the eternal song of worship and devotion.
God who calls us to life beyond what we can dream.
In you all things live and move and have being. In all things you live and move and express your artistry. Divine Word, your grace fills every moment of time and every fragment of matter. And so, in faith and expectation, in wonder and celebration, we remember this mystery. Divine flesh, you are born among us, and the Creator is clothed in creation. Divine Spirit, you contain all that has been formed. Divine life, you are the pulse of what that will be.
Blessed are you, Creator of the universe. From seeds sown into the earth, you have given us the gift of bread to feed and nourish us. At Jesus' last meal with his friends before facing the cross, he took the bread, blessed it and broke it, and then passed it among them, saying, "This is my body, broken for you. Take and eat and do this to remember me." Blessed are you, giver of life. From grapes which grow ripe and sweet on the vine, you have given us the gift of juice to refresh and heal us. After the meal, Jesus took the cup and blessed it. And then he passed it among them, saying, "This is my blood shed for you. Take and drink and do this to remember me." And now we come to your table again, Jesus, mindful of how you have laid your life down so that all of creation could be born again in us, including us. Mindful of how you took your life up again so that all creation could be filled with life abundant, including us. Mindful that we cannot earn or purchase this privilege, but that it is your grace which beckons us and your grace which ensures us that all creation may be one and whole. May your Spirit work in these fruits of earth so that they may become for us a sharing of Christ's blood and blood. Body. May your Spirit work in us, children of earth, so that we may be transformed into Christ's body, carrying life, care, and salvation to all creation. As children of life, we pray the prayer Jesus taught us, saying, "Loving God, in whom is heaven, the hallowing of your name echoes through the universe. The way of your justice be followed by the peoples of the earth. Your heavenly will be done by all created beings. Your commonwealth of peace and freedom sustain our hope and come on earth. With the bread we need for today, feed us. In the hurts we absorb from one another, forgive us. In times of temptation and test, spare us. From the grip of all that is evil, free us. For you reign in the glory of the power that is love, now and forever. Amen."
We invite our communion servers to come forward at this time. In the United Methodist Church, we practice open communion. That is to say, we place no barrier between you and this table. All who are seeking the grace of Christ are welcome today. You'll receive the elements through intinction. You will be given a piece of the bread, and then you'll dip it in the cup of juice and receive the elements together. You're invited to pray at the rails. And we want you to know that there's a gluten-free option at the center table, and all of our cups have juice for an inclusive ministry to all. There are parish aid plates at either side of the centers so that you can help give to money that our clergy team can use to give to immediate needs to people who are in emergency situations. You'll come by the center aisle of your section and return by the side aisles. The table is set. All are welcome at this table. Take the bread and dip it and pray for communion for all.
I see trees of green, red roses too. Oh, myself, oh yes, what a wonderful world. Oh, this is a wonderful world. I see skies of blue and clouds of white, the bright, blessed day. Sacred night, and I think to myself, oh yes, oh yes, what a wonderful, wonderful world. Ooh, the colors of the rainbow are so pretty in the sky. Shaking hands, saying, how do you do? What they're really saying is, I love you. I see the babies cry. Oh, I'll watch them grow, and they learn so much more. Oh, than I. This is a wonderful world that he's got in his hands. Don't you know he's got the whole world in his hands. He's got the whole world in his hands. He's got the in his hands, he's got you and me, brother. In his hands, he's got you and me, sister. In his hands, he's got the whole world in his hands. Hey! More than I ever know, and This is a wonderful world. Oh, and thank God he's got it in his hands. Oh, he's got the whole world. The whole wonderful world. He's got the whole world in his hands. In his hands. Sister, he's holding us just like a baby. Oh, he's got the world in his hands. Oh, we're so lucky, he's got the world in his hands. We're so blessed, he's got the world in his hands. Ooh, he's got the piano player in his hands. He's got the guitarist in his hands. Oh, yeah. He's got the choir in his hands. He's got me in his hands. He's got the whole world in his hands. He's got you and me. Thank you.
How can our hearts not be filled with gratitude when we see the beautiful images of the creation, when we sense the presence of God's Spirit moving among us as people called to be a blessing? The ministries of this church make a difference in the world as we stand for justice, as we proclaim love into the world that is so easily distracted by hatred. We are a message of hope. And so our offerings, as we give them to God, enable us to stretch our arms wider and into the neighborhood and into the world. And so we ask that you give your tithes, gifts, and offerings this morning as an act of gratitude and thanksgiving, as an act of praise and a way of reaching your hands and your heart into the world, that we might bless the whole creation. Our ushers will move among us now to receive our morning tithes, gifts, and offerings.
Thank you.
gracious and loving God, we thank you for all the love that moves around the globe this day. We thank you for the love in this room that we have for one another and for your creation. We give thanks to you for life and love and breath, and we offer these gifts to you now that you may use them to your glory and to the blessing of the world. We pray this in the name of the Christ who gave all for us. Amen. I invite you to be seated as we have our closing celebration. I want to thank you for coming today. And if you are a guest, we hope that you will come again. If you're a member, we hope that you will come again. We're so glad that you are here, and we want to give a special thanks for the choir today. Would you give them a round of applause and thanksgiving? And I'd like for you to give thanks to our special guest musicians this day and for our director of music, Mark Squire. brothers and sisters, siblings, fellow travelers on this beautiful blue earth, go from this place knowing that you are loved deeply by the Creator God. You are loved and sustained by Jesus, who is our Savior and who brings new life and resurrection into all of creation. As we go, we know that you are filled with the Holy Spirit, the breath of life that continues to vibrate and pulsate through all of creation, empowering us to be blessing, love, and light into the world. Go, for you are on a mission that matters. Go and spread hope into the world. In the name of Jesus, amen.
Amen.